Sri Rupiyo Namaha children. In the last session, we have discussed about the file pointers. Today, we'll discuss how to update records in a file. Updating records in a file. Updating means changing its value and storing it again. Updating records in a file. Locate a record to be updated by searching for it. Make changes in the loader record and the memory, then write back onto the file at the exact location of old records. So, how we are going to find the exact location? To determine the exact location of the record, first we have to open the file in both read and write mode. To locate the record, first we have to store the position of file pointer, let us assume it as RPOS, before reading the record. After storing the position, read the record from the file and search the key in it through the appropriate test condition. If it is found, your desired record start position is available for you, so it is ready to make changes. Make changes in the record by changing its value in the memory as desired. Write back onto the file at the exact location. So we have stored the exact location in RPOS. Then you are going to change the contents of your record. Place the file pointer at the stored record position, that is your exact location, using your seek function. Write the modifier record now. Any operation like read or write takes place at the current file pointer position. Then place the file pointer must be in the beginning of the record to be overwritten. It may be reading or writing. Your file pointer should be in the beginning of your record position. Now, this is the program that we have seen already. In stu.dat, we have stored the contents of your file. We have written some contents into the file. And let us see what are the contents in the file. Right? These are the contents that we have stored in stu.dat file. So here we are going to change based on your marks. That is, we are going to change the marks here. It's based on the condition, we are going to change it. Now we'll see how to update the records in your file. So we have used pickle module and stu is an empty dictionary. If the record has been found, we are going to set it as a true, otherwise it is false. Open the file stu.dat in both the modes, that is RB plus, both in reading mode and as well as in writing mode. F1 is a file handle. So R position equal to fin dot tilde. It stores the file pointer position before reading. That is, the beginning of your record positions, it stores in ROS. So stu equal to pickle dot load of fin. So it reads the content, that is, it reconstructs the constant from your file stu.dat and it checks whether marks are greater than 81, that is from your stu dictionary. It checks with the referencing key element. If the marks are greater than 80, we are going to add plus 2 values to the marks, to the value we are going to add it. Now, if the marks are greater than 81 in the sense, we have to change it. That is, we are changing only in the dictionary but not in the file. So we have to be back to the file pointer. That's why we have reading the, before reading the record from your file, we are storing the initial position at RPOS. So using that value, we are changing the file pointer's position to that exact record of the file, and we are going to change the value. So to change the value, we are going to use jump off stu comma fin. That is fin, which is nothing but it is being associated on the file, stu, which is nothing but a dictionary where we have changed the dictionary element value by +2 based on the condition. Then that associated value we are going to store it into the record. That is, we are going to store it into the file. The process will be repeated till it reads all the records from your file, and every time it stores into the file, and finally we are storing found as true. And if the record has not been found, that is, if it does not satisfy with the condition, we are not going to process this step. That is, we are not going to rewrite the contents into the file. So your found will be false. In such case, it prints as sorry, no matching record found. Otherwise, it prints as record successfully updated. Now we'll execute this. Records updated successfully. Now we'll open that file whether the records have been updated or not. File, open. So now let us execute this file. Right. So here you can notice that all the records which are greater than 85 with the marks which are greater than 81 only, we are going to store. That is, we are going to add two more values to your marks. So here the condition, here already it is 85.5. So as it satisfies with the condition, we are incrementing the value by 2. So it becomes 87.5. And rest of the records, as it does not match with the condition, so the value remains the same. This is how we'll be executing the program. That is, using the current location. That is, here first, every time we are reading, we are storing the file pointer position before reading the record. Once we have stored that file pointer, we are checking with these values. That is, we are going to check whether it satisfies with the condition, and we are placing the file pointer back into the initial position there. Then we are going to restore the values. That is, we are going to rewrite the contents using your dump function. Thank you, children.